This place witnessed something we have never witnessed before in all of our years of the Civil War.
Greetings, dear friends. It is almost a year since the catastrophic blast that ripped through Beirut on August 4, 2020. In the last few weeks, we have seen a bleak story unfolding from the country. Families have been on the streets demanding answers and justice for their loved ones. A fuel crisis has led to miles of cars queuing for fuel and increasing frustration. Medicines have been in short supply and families are going hungry. As the anniversary arrives, I would ask you to join us in prayer for the country, that mounting tensions are diffused and the neediest people are able to access what they need. With thanks to all of you, Sat7 was able to offer physical and spiritual support to many viewers who live in Beirut. And we have continued to walk with them through this challenging time. In the immediate aftermath of the blast, a new project was created in partnership with the Danish government and the Danish Bible Society to build on the incredible response from the ordinary people that was seen across the world, as people of all religious and ethnic groups and all ages went on to the streets to help whomever they could, united in grief and in their love for their country. No group was more active than the youth of Beirut, who have already lived through so much. At this time, when the economic crisis is pushing the people of Lebanon into sectarian divisions once more, I ask you all to pray that the first activities of this partnership project will go ahead. That is, will help bring youth together from across these divides to build bridges, unity and trust for a younger generation. So it indeed the new story becomes Lebanon, our story. I ask you to pray for this in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you.